Like most other smartphone makers, HTC delivers a new flagship smartphone every year in the spring. Like everyone else's, HTC's new device is typically bigger, faster, and more expensive than the previous version. And the brand new HTC U12 Plus is definitely no exception to that rule. As you might expect, there is a lot to like about the U12 Plus. It has a 6-inch Quad HD Plus Super LCD 6 display, which fares pretty well in outdoor visibility. It's powered by a Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 chip, which chews up and spits out practically anything that you throw at it. The base model has 6 GB of RAM, which is a dream for those who love jumping in and out of apps all day long. And it also has a dual camera on the back, which captures absolutely stunning photos. But like most other smartphones, there are a few issues to deal with. So before we jump into the details on the good stuff, let's take a look at what's holding this phone back. The most obvious issue, at least for those in the US, is the lack of carrier support. This may not matter for other countries, but it's a big deal since most US customers still walk into their carrier stores to buy their smartphones. By not being on display in stores and the carrier's websites, sales of the U12 Plus will probably fare even worse than last year's U11, which was actually picked up by Sprint. Of course, an unlocked version of the phone can be purchased from HTC and Amazon, which works perfectly well with AT&T, T-Mobile, and Verizon, but that's still unlikely to move the needle. The second issue is the price. HTC is selling the U12 Plus for $800. When you consider the specs, it's not a bad deal, but it is $150 more than what HTC was charging for the U11 last year. Sure, you do get double the cameras, a larger display, and a bigger battery. But there are those who simply can't afford $800 on a smartphone, or simply don't want to pay that much for a device that doesn't have a Samsung or Apple logo on the back of it. For number three, let's talk about battery life. A 3,500 mAh cell should be plenty to keep the U12 Plus chugging along through a full day's work. And for the most part, it does the job. But I have had a few days that the battery just can't keep up. On average, the U12 Plus has given me 13 hours on a single charge, but if I want to stretch things out into the evening, I need to limit screen on time for the day, keeping it below 4 hours. That's not terrible, but it's definitely less than what I got with the U11, which had only a 3,000 mAh cell. The phone's front-facing cameras and its software also take the number 4 and number 5 slots on things that need improvement, but you'll hear about those in just a minute. Now, let's get to the good stuff. I've always had a love-hate relationship with glass-back smartphones, and things really aren't different with the U12 Plus. The translucent blue color option is absolutely stunning, and it's hard to describe the feeling that you get when you peer through the glass at the phone's internal components. It would be nice if more of the glass was transparent, but HTC cheeses you with just enough so that you're always taking a second look whenever the lighting is just right, just in case you might see something more. Of course, a glass-back smartphone does have its downsides as well. The device slips off almost every surface that you place it on. Honestly, my review unit slipped off my countertop 10 minutes after I did my unboxing. The good news is that it survived that drop and a few others without a scratch. There's no telling how long the U12 Plus will hold up over time, but I can tell you this, you will be constantly living in fear that you're going to be cracking the back of this phone. While the U12 Plus has the same size display as the U11 Plus, the phone is slightly smaller thanks to smaller bezels above and below the display. And the phone's metal frame includes new EdgeSense 2.0 sensors, which can now detect how you're holding the phone, allowing for a few new features. The first one on the list is grip detection, which allows the phone's display orientation to lock based on how you're holding the device. This means that you can read while in bed or lying on the couch without having to fiddle with the auto rotate setting. Next is the double tap gesture, which allows you to trigger an action by double tapping the edge of the phone with your thumb. By default, the double tap enables one-handed mode, shrinking the screen towards the edge of the phone that you tapped on. Like the long and short squeeze actions though, the double tap can also be configured to launch any application that you want. But HTC's engineers didn't stop there. They chose to ditch the traditional buttons on the side of the phone, replacing them with pressure-sensitive ones. The power and volume keys don't actually move and are actually a part of the metal frame. When you press them, the side of the phone actually vibrates, giving you the feeling that you've pressed a physical button, similar to Apple's Force Touch trackpads. It's definitely not as satisfying as pressing a button with a nice click to it, but there's nothing wrong with it either. It helps with the phone's IP68 dust and water resistance, and it should actually reduce the chances that your buttons will actually stop working over time. When it comes to software, the phone is running on Android 8.0 with the March security update. And then there's HTC Sense, which feels actually quite antiquated at this point. The app drawer and the notification shade can be opened by swiping up or down anywhere on the home screen, and you also get rounded app icons, but those design tweaks were actually introduced last year on the U11 Plus. Everything else looks and feels like the HTC Sense software experience that we got on the HTC 10. Blink Feed is the same as ever, but it actually feels packed more with ads than it was before. And then there's the HTC Sense Companion, which will pop up in your notification shade until you finally set it up. HTC's AI-driven personal assistant actually isn't worth mentioning since it really doesn't do much. So it is a good thing then that the phone gives you wake word access to the Google Assistant and Amazon's Alexa. It seems that HTC Sense's only redeeming factor is that it's one of the lightest OEM skins out there, allowing the phone's Snapdragon 845 chip and 6GB of RAM to truly show off their power. Now, I'm not exaggerating at all when I say that there's absolutely nothing that the processor in this phone can't handle. And having 6GB of RAM means that you can multitask to your heart's content, jumping in and out of apps without ever having to wait for them to reload, and even picking up on games hours later exactly where you left off. The base model comes with 64GB of storage, and you also get a microSD card slot. And that brings us to the U12 Plus's main highlight, its cameras. As mentioned before, you get a total of 4 sensors, 2 on the back and 2 on the front, allowing you to take portrait-style pictures and selfies with a digitally enhanced bokeh effect that HTC actually introduced us to 4 years ago with the HTC One M8. But while HTC hasn't been using dual camera sensors on its flagship devices the last couple years, the results that you get out of the dual 12-megapixel camera sensors on the back of the U12 Plus are surprisingly good and pretty much on par with what you can get out of the Huawei P20, which is one of the leaders in this space. The effect can be changed after the fact, allowing you to adjust the blur or even change the focal point. The main sensors are better than ever, delivering photos that are on par and sometimes even better than what you can get out of the Pixel 2 or the Samsung Galaxy S9. Low light shots do need a little bit of work since light sources do tend to get blown out from time to time, but the final results are still pretty impressive, especially when you turn on the Pro mode and tweak the settings yourself. Video capture is pretty good as well, delivering stunning 4K footage at 60 frames per second, or even 1080p video at 240 frames per second if you're looking to capture the world in slow motion. The U12 Plus does have optical and electronic image stabilization for the rear cameras, but it's not quite up to snuff when compared to other flagship devices from this year. But on the plus side, the U12 Plus does capture incredible audio while recording video, thanks to the 4 microphones which are located on the different sides of the phone. There's even an acoustic zoom feature which focuses the audio in on your subject if you zoom in while recording your video. But the overall camera experience on the U12 Plus is brought down a little bit by its front-facing cameras. The 2 8-megapixel sensors that HTC is using should be more than capable of delivering great selfies, but the results actually leave a lot to be desired. The bokeh effect only seems to get things right a bit more than half the time, leaving you with unusable pictures or forcing you to reshoot the shots. It's surprising how inconsistent the results are when compared to the Pixel 2, which actually pulls off the same effect with only using one camera. Naturally, an HTC review wouldn't be complete without mentioning the phone's audio experience. Disappointingly though, the phone uses HTC's Boomsound Hi-Fi speaker system, which splits the highs and the lows between the front and the bottom speakers. The overall audio quality though is really good when you compare it to other smartphones, but it's definitely not as rich as the stereo Boomsound speaker setups that we got in the past. And then there's the USONIC USB-C headphones, which come in the box. They're identical to what HTC shipped last year with the U11, offering pretty decent active noise cancellation, but what really sets them apart is the custom audio profiles, which are tuned specifically to the user's ear canal, delivering a richer, more immersive sound than what you would typically get from a pair of $100 headphones. Despite a few minor setbacks, the HTC U12 Plus is quite an impressive device. I'm not sure if the phone is substantially better than the Samsung Galaxy S9 or the Huawei P20 Pro, but it's at least on the same playing field, capable of holding its own. If you're looking for a device with a unique design, impressive camera experience, and top-of-the-line performance, the HTC U12 Plus could definitely be the right device for you.